All right, now we'll get back to the questions in just a moment. But now we'd like to welcome Tim back to the show. Hi, Tim.
Hey,
welcome
guys.
Back, Tim.
Good
how
to see
are
you again.
Good to see you, as always.
Hey, you got lots of good toys.
I do. Today, we're going to talk about, kind of connects to your first thing.
Yeah.
We're going to talk about magnetism.
All right.
Now, a lot of times when you think of magnetism, you think
like
just
that.
Paper clips
exactly what I think
and magnets.
Mm-hmm.
But when you really think about magnetism, it's the glue that holds everything together in the universe. All your atoms are held together
powerful.
Because it's electrical. It's a charge. It's positive and negative. That's how your atoms hold together. And you get your basic magnet. And your magnet will have a north and a south pole.
Okay, right.
And, of course,
opposites
north and
attract.
South. Opposites attract. Mm-hmm. But when you take them and you put them against each other, they'll turn right around.
And isn't that cool? Look at that.
It
yeah.
actually repels it, but it spins it around and it grabs it. Uh-huh. And it does it because there's a magnetic field. This magnet has not only the energy coming out and going in, but it goes all the way around. Cool way to see that is right here with this.
Oh, cool.
That
here's
is very
magnet.
Cool. Can you show how that gets started? Like
oh,
you
yeah,
did
yeah,
for
yeah.
me earlier in the show
take,
today?
Yep. You
yeah,
take the
see,
magnet
look at
out,
that. Like
and
dust
it's just iron
filings.
Almost.
Called iron
and
filings.
You put them inside. Uh-huh. And I usually shake it up a little bit
that
just to get it
so
going.
That is so cool, Tim. Mm-hmm.
And right there, you can see that the magnetic mm-hmm. field is all the way around it.
Uh-huh.
And magnetism has been around since the dawn of time, of course. But the first people to actually start to think about magnetism, the Greeks, because they had lodestones.
Yeah.
And they talked about how the lodestones actually attracted the iron. Mm-hmm. So it was really pretty neat how it worked out. And then it worked along. The Chinese came up with the same idea. But in the about the 1100s, the Chinese came up with using the magnet for a compass.
Okay.
They used a lodestone
and
they pounded it out.
Mr. Z's science challenge.
Exactly.
Uh-huh.
Exactly. But the really cool thing, there's all these different magnets. There's when you came to electromagnets,
perfect.
That happened around 1819.
Okay.
And this guy, Oster, he was from Copenhagen, and he was working with a magnet, and he had a little metal wire that he had electricity going through, and he didn't even notice it was by accident. He noticed that the magnet started to wiggle.
Uh-huh.
And when the compass started to wiggle,
mm-hmm.
and he figured out that it was the electricity that was doing it. So then for the next 10 or 15 years, they worked a lot on it. And it was really neat. So now I want to show you guys a couple of ways that kids
right.
at home
right.
can
mm-hmm.
do electromagnet. I've got this little AA battery, and I've got it hooked up in a little battery holder, easy to buy at any
mm-hmm.
electronic
okay.
store.
So that's your power source
that's
there.
My power right. source. And I'll connect one side. This nail, I have this basic type of wire. It's
mm-hmm.
just your basic stereo wire.
All right.
And wrapped around it. And the more coils you put on it,
the more powerful the
more
magnet,
powerful.
I would guess.
It's the
yeah.
same.
Yeah.
Let's see
makes
now
sense.
If we can pick some.
Well, it's trying.
Yeah.
It's trying like heck. Let's see if we can get a little one.
There you go.
There you go. It's not very strong.
Yeah.
Because
no.
it's not many coils. But let's
Is
see.
It also a matter of the thickness of the coil they wrap around it?
Not so much the
too?
Thickness, but the
numbers. Just the number of them. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Now we'll
okay.
try the same power with, this guy has about 3 meters of
okay.
wire. So it's been wrapped around
coils.
Probably
okay.
30, 40 times. So let's see if we can actually
All right.
make the battery do a little bit better for us.
Oh, yeah. Oh, look at that. Yeah.
The
much more powerful.
Yeah.
The more the coil.
And that's interesting. Not more the coil. I mean, just not a matter of thickness or anything. Just a matter
no, just
of how
number
many
of coils
you put around there.
It's the matter
Never
of what kind of energy source you use. We use a D battery,
mm-hmm.
and you hook up. Where's my little guy? We hook up a D battery to him, and this time this should be able to pick up quite a few.
D battery is just
a little
more
bit
powerful
stronger.
Source.
More stronger source.
It looks like
more
it
current.
For
and
sure.
actually yeah. more current.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
exactly.
Same voltage. Yeah.
And turn around. We'll put it on the big guy, uh-huh. and we'll see if we can't.
Oh yeah, look at those heavy nails.
Yeah.
yeah.
Pick up.
And
the
while you're
nails.
Picking up those nails, it's kind of interesting. Let's go back to what you said earlier. You know, until the Iron Age, until we actually were able to get iron. Uh-huh. Nobody knows about
no, the, never,
and no the one best, noticed the magnets.
Exactly.
Right?
The best part of electromagnets is how they're used. They're used in everything from speakers to amplifiers, but they also use them in salvage yards
uh-huh.
to go along and they pick up metal. And when you disconnect,
That's amazing.
The electricity drops right out.
You know, I'd like to ask you two guys, as scientists, how often are things discovered, like in 1818, by accident?
That is so impressive.
A lot more than you think.
Serendipity is a great subject with science.
And I'm sure you guys must run into classroom situations. You're like, what happened here?
You tell the kids in the classroom, you know, when they're experimenting, they come up with a hypothesis, and at first they say, oh, it's terrible. I got the wrong results. Or, you know, it didn't prove my hypothesis. But every time we discover something else.
Yep. Oh, that is great.
Yeah, I talk about when they asked Edison one time if he was getting frustrated that he hadn't invented the light bulb yet that he'd been working on. He goes, no, I've discovered 200 ways not to make a light bulb.
Exactly.
You know,
The cool thing is, when you talk to kids about magnetism, they say metals, that all metals. Mm-hmm. But not all metals are magnetic.
Right.
Let me show you.
All right, great. We think of our refrigerator
Where's my little guy right down here? I've got my aluminum tube. And the aluminum tube, I've got a neodymium magnet. It's a rare earth magnet. Put it on there.
Doesn't stick. All right.
But watch, if we hold it, and I'll hold it here. When I say go, you count to see how long it gets in my hand.
Like a billionth of a second.
Like a second. Maybe 1 second. We'll do it twice. Go. 1 second. Now, here's the thing. Because this is aluminum and it's conductive, now count when I say go. Go.
1, 2, 3. Whoa, that went through slowly. Wish we could see the inside of that.
I wish you could, because if you take a look at the inside, it starts to wobble back and forth.
You were showing me earlier in the show. That is so cool.
Lenz's law.
Slowly that thing moved through the tube.
It generates a little electric current. That electric current changes into a magnetic field. And when it does,
so this is kind of the opposite of what we saw with the electromagnet, where the electric current was generating a magnetic field. Now his magnetic field.
And that field is kind of forcing it to stay up.
It resists it falling down, so it keeps grabbing it.
Remember,
it's opposite.
We looked before, what happens with the opposites?
One more thing. I think I got time to show you. This real easy thing, that's the neatest. Anybody can do it. You take an aluminum can. You take a balloon. You rub it on your hair.
When we were kids.
What does it build up?
Static charge.
Now watch.
And look at that. It's leading. That's great. And that, anybody can do that at home. Okay, now why does that work, Tim?
Same idea. It draws, it's an electromagnet, basically. It has a charge to it, and that charge actually starts
to
draw the... Although, if you take a magnet and you put it against the can...
It's still not, but it's just
that electrical charge that actually does it.
Exactly, because what happens that is the electrons that are in those atoms of the metal in the can actually kind of push to the other side. There's a London dispersion going on there, and it's actually being attracted now by the positive nuclei of those atoms. So
it can do that. It's actually separating in that way.
Yeah, they kind of push away to the other side a little.
That's great. Tim did a great job.
So it's all science. It's all... magnetism, you could sit there and talk about it for hours.
Joe often tells me, nothing happens without science.
That's right.
That's exactly
right. We saw a lot of things happen here today.
Not to be able to
I have to talk about
some good things
later
to be said for mathematics stuff.
This is great. All right, well, thanks, Tim. Now, we'd like to thank Tim for being here. Now, if you want to see this experiment again or others like it, remember to learn more about the Rochester Museum and Science Center. You can go to our website, homeworkhotline.org. But stay right there, and we'll be back in just a second.
All right.